Hi friends, in this video I will cover ISRO Scientist 2017 December paper. I will cover question number 62 onwards. Here in these questions options are wrong, that's why they omitted this question while evaluation. Its correct answer is maximum value of reduction, delta value we have to calculate, or delta marks also you can write. And we know our formula is cos theta equal to 1 minus delta by 2r or 1 minus delta by diameter d. So from here delta by d equal to 1 minus cos theta. Here they are writing, instead of theta they are writing alpha. So cos alpha delta equal to d into 1 minus cos alpha. Here no option is available, that's why they omitted this question. Correct answer is this one, or you can write 2r 1 minus cos theta also, or cos alpha. Which of the following is true for vibration of a mechanical system? Damping ratio zeta is the ratio of critical damping to the actual damping. Damping ratio zeta is C by CC. C is your actual damping. CC is your critical damping. But its critical damping, actual damping is C. Here they are writing CC by C. But correct is C by CC. A not possible. Then damping can be obtained from the response of the system under forced vibration using logarithmic method. No, this is also not possible. Then for damped mechanical system, the amplitude of vibration tends to be infinity when excitation frequency omega reaches the system's natural frequency. Omega by omega n, it's became 1. Their amplitude of vibration, amplitude vibration A, here A by static deflection, it's coming infinity, but amplitude, here they are writing only amplitude, so this is also not possible. I am showing its graph in next page. If you follow this graph, amplitude ratio or A by XT, XT is a static deflection versus frequency ratio omega by omega n, here you will get infinity, amplitude ratio will become infinity when omega by omega n is it's zero. But here in this question they wrote amplitude of vibration, so C is wrong answer. Then amplitude ratio and transmissivity of a vibration isolator is unity when the frequency of excitation force is root 2 times the natural frequency. So omega by omega n, it's equal to root 2. Again, if you follow the graph also you can answer this question. Otherwise, if you put the values in formula also you will get your answer. Amplitude ratio again A by XST 1 by 1 minus omega by omega n square, its whole square, plus 2 zeta omega by omega n square, its whole square, then whole root over. Here omega by omega n, this term is root 2, its square you will get 2, then nothing is mentioned, so zeta is 0, this term will become 0, then you will get 1 by 1 minus root 2 square is 2, its square root over, you will get 1 by 1, unity is your answer. So amplitude ratio, unity, this is correct. Then for transmissivity, again we have to calculate. Transmissivity formula is 4 transmitted by 4 supplied. Its formula is 1 plus 2 zeta omega by omega n its square its minus 1 minus omega n by omega n its square whole square plus 2 zeta omega by omega n whole square whole root over. Zeta is 0, so this is 0. Here also it's 0. Again you will get omega by omega n, it's root 2, root 2 square is 2. Again same ft by f or transmissibility ratio tr, you will get 1. From this graph also you can answer this question. Transmissibility ratio or transmissibility versus frequency ratio omega by omega n. Here at if omega by omega n is its root 2, then TR value you will get 1. One more thing is important here. Here beyond root 2 value you have to give isolation plus damping. And if omega by omega n is less than root 2, then damping is not beneficial. Sorry, here below root 2 value damping is beneficial. Damping is and after root 2 value here both damping and isolation. Only damping is harmful. So we are giving isolation also. So here D is your correct answer. Both amplitude ratio and transmissibility TR. TR is force transmitted divided by force applied. It becomes unity when omega by omega n is root. Question number 64. What is the maximum rate that a heat pump which uses 1 kilowatt of electric power can supply heat to a house 27 degree Celsius when the outside temperature is 12 degree Celsius? So here it's a heat pump. Minimum temperature is T minimum, then T maximum is maximum temperature. It's a heat pump. Anticlockwise cycle. What done on the system? Q2 is, it's a heat pump. Q2 is heat extracted and Q1 is heat rejected by the heat pump. Q2 is heat extracted by the heat pump and Q1 is heat rejected by the heat pump. So here what done is 1 kilowatt maximum rate they ask. So it's a Carnot cycle. Maximum rate then Carnot then ideal then reversible. If they will mention, then you have to go for Carnot cycle COP. Carnot cycle COP. COP, it's a heat pump, so it's normally it's desired effect divided by work done or refrigerating effect by work done. For Carnot cycle, refrigerating effect is or your COP. For heat pump, desired effect is maximum temperature. T maximum divided by work done is T max minus T minimum. This is Carnot COP. Or for maximum rate they ask, that's why we will use this one. Then actual COP is desired effect is Q1 by work done. This is your actual COP. Here they ask for maximum rate, so actual COP equal to ideal COP or Carnot COP. So Q1 by work done equal to maximum temperature is 27 degree Celsius plus 273 300 Kelvin, then T max minus T minimum you will get 27 minus 12 you will get 15, here you will get 20. Then your watt done is 1 kilowatt, so Q1 equal to 20 kilowatt or kilojoule per second. Your options are in kilojoule per second, that's why I am writing kilojoule per second. C is your correct answer. Here, definite integral question, you just separate them. Dx dy, then 0 to 1, 1 by 1 minus x square root over dx, 0 to 1, y square dy root over, take x term as constant while integrating the y term. One by one minus y square, it's sine inverse y, upper limit one, lower limit zero. So sine inverse one equal to pi by two and sine inverse zero equal to zero. So you will get pi by two into this one also we will solve. One by one minus x square, it's sine inverse x, 0 to 1. Again here also you will get sine inverse 1 equal to pi by 2 and sine inverse 0 equal to 0. So pi by 2 into pi by 2. D is your correct answer. Question is, white iron consists of, white iron structure consists of its perlite and cementite or Fe3C. D is your correct answer. Question is, a cantilever beam of rectangular cross section depth D, width B and length L is subjected to a shear force F at its free end as shown in figure. The beam is made up of a material which follows maximum shear stress theory. Which of following is true? So here its theory part is very lengthy. Bit by bit we will solve. Method of elimination we will do. First one is, the beam section has uniform shear stress of F by BD. We know for beam shear stress formula is tau s equal to Fs A y bar I into B divided by I into B. I is your moment of inertia of entire cross section above neutral axis. Na, this is neutral axis. B is width at the level of MN only and Fs is your shear force. Area is area of cross section above NN, MN only. This green color, this one represents area of the cross section above MN only. And G here center of gravity of the area above MN. Y bar is the distance of center of gravity of that area from neutral axis. So here shear stress Fs is constant, area is changing, then your y bar also changing or its variable, I is constant, B also constant. So but these things A and y bar both are changing. So tau s also changing. First option A, the beam section uniform shear stress of F by BD. Not possible because your area also changing, y bar also changing. Then maximum shear stress in section and maximum bending stress in beam is equal when L equal to D by 2. So maximum shear stress value we have to calculate. So option B, Fs we will consider as shear force, F then maximum area we will take above neutral axis, b into d by 2. Then your y bar maximum, distance of cg from neutral axis of that cross section, its maximum value we will take, because we have to calculate shear force maximum. So it's d by 4. Then moment of inertia, it's bdq by 2l and b equal to b. So tau max we will calculate f into a into y bar divided by I into b, f into here b into area is b into d by 2 into y bar is d by 4 divided by bdq by 12 into b. If you solve this one, you will get 3f by 2 bd. This is your maximum shear stress. And bending value, we have to calculate bending moment maximum. Sigma b maximum is, from bending equation, we will get m by I into y maximum. And put the values, moment. Moment is F into L. L is your distance. Divided by I is BDQ by 2L. Into Y maximum, it's D by 2. But here in this case, it's D by 4. Here it's D by 2. This is for bending moment. And here, it's Y bar. Y bar is d by 4, here y maximum this is. So here, if you solve this one, L equal to, here already given in this question, L equal to d by 2. So here also you write, instead of L, you write d by 2. If you solve this one, you will get 3 will come, 3f divided by bd. Your maximum stress you are getting 3f by 2bd, and bending stress maximum you are getting 3f by bd. So tau max is not equal to bending stress maximum, so b not possible. Then go for c option. First, we will check D option. A not possible, B also not possible. D is easy because bending stress developed in the beam is independent of B. B is your width, and we know bending stress is M by I into Y maximum. I term you will get BDQ by 2L. So, sigma B is inversely proportional to B. So here it's independent. D not possible. Method of elimination also you can answer option C. Otherwise, if you want, you can check L is greater than D by 2, bending stress decide the failure stress. Failure stress means bending stress is more than your shear stress. So L is greater than D by 2. You put, then you check bending stress and your shear stress value. So greater than d by 2, any value you can check. So we will assume L equal to 3 by 4 d or 0.75 d it will come. 3 by 4 is 0.75. Then sigma b bending value we will calculate. Sigma b equal to m by I into y maximum. So m is f into L, then I is bdq by 2l, y maximum same you will get d by 2. So f is L equal to 3 by 4 d. So put the value here, f into 3 by 4 d into d by 2 divided by bdq by 2l. If you solve this one, you will get 9 by 2 FBD or 4.5 f by bd. Then shear stress value we have to calculate. F into A into y bar divided by I into B. F is F. Then area. Area is B into D by 2 into y bar is D by 4 divided by BD cube by 12 into B. If you solve this one already I solved. 3 by 2 F by BD. Or 1.5 F by BD. So from here, your bending stress is 4.5 F by BD and your shear stress is 1.5 F by BD. So your bending stress is greater than the shear stress. So your deciding factor will be your bending stress. So from option C is your correct answer. And we know in case of designing, we always take the maximum stress value for calculation of failure stress. So your bending stress is greater than shear stress. That's why you are taking bending stress decide the failure stress. C is your correct answer.